Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Annette. Happy birthday to you. I'm so sorry about that. If you are new, hi, my name is Nikki. I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today is Annette's birthday, hence this video and this collab, as you may have read by the title. So, yeah, happy birthday, my dear, dear friend. And I hope you will have many, many more and that you will have a fantastic day today. This collab, however, was thought of by, well, started by Prue from Prue LaRue. I will leave the picture up somewhere. And of course, all the information will be down in my description box. She thought it would be fun to, well, basically surprise Annette on her birthday and do a collab for her as a birthday present, where we either recreate one of her looks or let us be inspired by one of her looks. So yeah, during this video, I'm going to say her name in Dutch because, yeah, if you don't know, Annette is Norwegian. She lives in the US, but she is Norwegian, and her the pronunciation in Norwegian is well close to the Dutch pronunciation. So I'm going to choose to call her Annette, as I would if she were Dutch. So yeah, I don't really... It's going to be all over the place again, as usual. So grab a drink, grab a snack, and I hope this won't be too long. But yeah, I don't really know how many of us are in the collab as I am filming this, but I will leave all the channels listed down below. So yeah, and of course Prue's channel, Annette's channel, and the video that I am going to use to recreate one of her looks will also be down in the description box, and maybe even in this video as well. I have downloaded the video. Yes, I know how to do things. And maybe I will put kind of a picture in picture up, you know, so you can kind of see the video as you're watching this. I'm not sure yet. I sometimes have ideas and I'm not really able to execute them, but we will see nonetheless. Anyway, it will be listed down in my description box. What did I do? I kind of went searching on her Instagram to posts from 1 year ago around this time. I found one. But I also kind of, it's handy if I have the same palette as her. So I found this picture, which she did with the Hasina too, that I have here as well. And it is of her first impression with the Hasina too. The video went up later than the Instagram post, but I don't care. I'm going to recreate her look. Hence the fact that I will probably try to put it picture in picture. I don't know if I don't know. To be quite honest, I think it would be fun, but I don't really know how to film it then, so yeah, you just have to bear with me. So yeah, Hasina too. I have the video on my laptop as well, so if I'm looking that way, it is because I have the video there. And I'm just going to, well, try and recreate her look. The lipstick I have on already is one from Catrice. It is the closest I am able to come to the color that she has on her lips, because she didn't put it in her description box. So I don't know. I'm guessing. But that's okay. So yeah, let me get some brushes ready. And please do not look too closely at my base makeup, because yeah, I'm trying out older foundations because I want to declutter my foundations. I'm trying out some older ones. This does not really want to play nice with the rest of my makeup. So don't look too close. Yeah, okay. Let me get my brushes ready, and then, well, we can basically get started. Oh yeah, I already put eye primer on my eye, and I did not set it. The eye primer is the Smashbox Lip Primer in Light, just so you know. Okay, yeah, I think something like that. Okay, so I grabbed some brushes here, and it is so fun to see her video of a year ago, and to see how much she has grown in front of the camera. And same with me, basically. If I watch videos from a year ago, I'm not really ashamed of myself very quickly, but I'm like, oh Lord. Okay, so let me pull up the video and then kind of start where she is, well, going to start with the first shadow. So let me get a brush ready. Oh, I'm kind of nervous. I've recreated someone's look from an Instagram picture, but never like this. So, wish me luck. Yeah.
using a lot of them. So I'm gonna start off by taking Anika, which is this light blue matte. And I'm taking this on my Morphe M321 brush, and I'm going to start placing this in my inner corner as a transition shade. And I'll be using three different shades here on my crease. So I'm just starting off by tapping this on to get the most pigment that I can.
Okay, so I'm tapping it on as well. Because it's actually a technique that I use too. Something like that. Okay, let's go to the video again.
Next, I want to go in with Re, which is like a teal color. And I'm using my same brush. The palette does not have a lot of kick up in the pan, which is great. And I'm going to be placing this one right next to the blue that I just put down.
Now, we kind of have the same techniques with slight variations, but usually kind of the same techniques. We also start with a non-set base, usually, and then stamp the color on and then blend it out. And then here I'm kind of stamping over. What I am going to do now though is take a blending brush, small, and I'm just going to make sure it's clean. Blend the edge a tiny bit. Just blend here to get the two colors to mix. Let me get my mirror so I can see what I'm doing. And just make sure it's kind of evenish. And kind of ready for the third shade.
And next to that, I'm going to go into this dark purple. I'm not sure how this is going to blend into the
Mohawk
teal that I just put down, but I hope that it'll be okay as long as I just tap it over and don't over blend. And I'm putting this in my outer corner and also pulling it down onto my lower lash line on the outer third.
And now I'm just going to make sure that it kind of flows the way it needs to. Her corner is a bit sharper than mine though, I can see. So, but she also has a different brush. And her eye shape is a bit different, but it does not really matter. So I'm just going to work this on my eyelid. I met Annette through Paulina, from Paulina Beauty. Paulina did a collab. I followed Paulina. I'm switching brushes to something that I can blend with. I followed Paulina for quite a while. And then she did a collab with Annette. When Annette was really, really tiny. And that is how I met Annette. So, yeah. And it is just so fantastic to see how she grows. Not only in front of the camera or behind the camera, whichever way you want to see it. But also that her channel grows and that she's becoming really successful. And that's so cool to watch, you know? She's very, very sweet. She's very talented. And yeah. I hope she goes viral. Okay. So, looking at it, they kind of want to mix. But I'm kind of losing the green. So I'm going to go back into the color called Re. I just cleaned the brush. I'm just going to do circles around the edge. Okay. I'm going to go front to back. So I'm starting with Annika, a little bit on my brush to help blend the edge. Now, Annette has hooded eyes. Mine are deep set and older. So we kind of use similar techniques. But yeah, I think I have more lid space here. I think her eyes are a bit smaller than mine as well. Does not really matter though. I'm just blending and making sure nothing is patchy and everything is nice. Okay, now I'm going to go to the purple called Mohan. Cleaning my brush. I forgot how pigmented these shadows were. Now I did, I think I did I do 3 looks with this palette or 5? I don't remember. I do remember though that I had a lot of trouble with this palette when I first got it. Just because I wasn't used to working with shadows like this. I learned a lot. I also learned that for me, I learned that I needed to build up these shades instead of blend them out. Now my techniques have changed since then, have improved, but also my eyeshadow base, because the eyeshadow base that I'm using now works really, really well with this palette, better than the eyeshadow base I was using then. I don't remember which one it was, but yeah. My skills have improved. So yeah, I am able to pack it on and blend it out now. If you are not, if your skill set is not there yet, start with fluffier brushes and then gradually go smaller so that you need to blend less. Does that make sense? I'm going to do the same on the other eye and then I will be back. Okay, so she's doing her lower lash line now. I'm going to start with the color Annika, which was the blue, and it's going to go here. And then the green called Ree goes in the middle. I think it's shimmer time now. Yeah. Okay. So let me get a brush for that. She sprayed her brush. I used to do that as well, but now I use glitter glue. So I'm going to place that first before I go in with the first shimmer. Just because that is how I do it now. Okay, I'm ready for my shimmer. So let's see.
I got this new BoxyCharm today, and it's just a flat concealer brush. So I'm going to start off by taking Jade, and I'm going to try it without wetting my brush first.
So yeah, I need to do the same on the other eye. Okay, so she's pulling it a little bit more in.
Into my inner corner and down.
Okay, so inner corner and lower lash line as well. I am going to take a different brush for that, and I'm going to spray because that is how I use shimmers on my lower lash line. Like that, I think.
Next, I'm going to use the purple shade to put in the middle here.
Okay, so the shimmers are blended. I do feel that she has her mattes a little bit closer to the shimmers, or maybe I just need to bring my shimmers up higher. So let's try that here. Yeah, then you can see them a bit better. I usually don't bring my shimmers up this high though. But I think it's cool nonetheless. So let me do that. Okay, she's going to do liner and mascara. She's going to do a wing liner. So let me do that as well. Okay, we are there. Mascara and liner is on. She also has an eye pencil.
For my waterline, I'm going to use this Marc Jacobs highlighter. And this is in the shade Mist Me, and it's just a pastel purple.
I don't have a pastel purple. I do, however, have this. This is from Catrice, and it is in bright lavender, but it is a little bit of a... An iridescent highlighter stuff thingy. So let's put that in the waterline. Yes. I think she also did mascara on her bottom lashes though, but I forgot. I don't know. Did she do that? Yes, I saw. So I'm going to kind of put a little bit on my bottom lashes as well. Inner corner highlight. I think she gets her face powder for that.
And just for an extra little pop in my inner corner, I'm going to use my Dior highlighter and go in with the white.
Okay, so for inner corner highlighter, she uses her Dior highlighter in white. I don't have a Dior highlighter. I do, however, I should have somewhere a white. I have a white highlighter here. So I have here in front of me the I Heart Revolution Praline palette, which is a face palette which has a white highlighter shade. So I'm going to do that. So here is the look just before the falsies. Because I wear falsies. I know Annette doesn't. I am going to wear falsies though. But to kind of keep it a little bit more soft, I will be choosing my natural ones. Wow. Which look like this. I'm going to put those on and then I will be back and show you the finished look. So falsies are on and here is my finished look. What I also did is I kind of changed up the lippy a little bit, because on top of the liquid lipstick that I had on, which was the Generation Matte from Catrice in Mauve to the Rhythm, I tapped a little bit of this, which is Essence This Is Me in Amazing, because I was kind of missing, it's still not the same because I don't have the same color, but it is kind of a little bit more pinky. So here is my recreation and follow along of Annette's first impression with the Hasina 2. Let me know if you think I succeeded. I think I came close. It's not the same, obviously, because our eye shapes aren't the same and our techniques are similar but slightly different. But still, I think it's really, really fun. I had a lot of fun doing this. Annette, happy birthday again. I love you to bits and I hope you'll have an amazing day today. And thank you, Prue, for coming up with this very, very cool and sweet collab. And yeah, asking, well, us to join you with this. That was it. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Don't forget to check out my description box for the channels that are there. Obviously, Annette's channel, but and the video that I used in this video today. Also, Prue's video or channel will be linked there. And all the other people that are in this collab will be linked in my description box. Go check them out, send them some love, and if you like them and plan to stick around there, tell them that I sent you. If you are over from one of the other channels, thank you so, so much for watching. I hope you will consider joining my weird and twisted little family where you are normal and I am not. Or something like that. But yeah, thank you so, so much for watching. Going to wish you an amazing day, a fabulous evening, and I hope to see you soon in my next one. Bye, guys. Wait, where's my mouse? Yeah, I know I need to move. Where's my mouse thingy?